boys.
Hello, Ratty. Such a perfect day. I had to get out of the house to breathe some fresh air. It doesn't happen often.
Well, you couldn't have picked a better time. Badger and I have hired a boat and are going to float downstream and enjoy picnic lunch. Care to join us?
Badger? Haven't seen him in some time.
You know Badger. Doesn't like crowds as a rule.
That looks like a fine looking picnic basket. What do you pack?
Let me think. I don't believe I've forgotten anything. There's cold chicken, cold tongue, cold ham, peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, salad, French rolls, watercress, tea biscuits, potted meat, ginger beer, lemonade, and soup.
Oh, stop. That sounds too good to be true.
And for dessert, two types of pudding, vanilla and butterscotch.
A choice between vanilla and butterscotch? How delicious!
Doesn't have to be a choice. Have a china plate of each.
A china plate of each? How generous, how friendly, how nimble. I'd be delighted to join you.
I'm coming, Ratty.
Hello, who's this?
Molly?
How are you, Molly?
Haven't seen you since last winter.
Hello, Badger.
Molly's gonna join us on our little picnic.
Splendid. I plan to clean the house. But I'll wait.
I went to Toad Hall. I thought Toad might join us, but the housekeeper said he was out, as usual.
I hope he hasn't gotten himself into more trouble. I suppose you chefs know that he smashed up that beautiful painted wagon. He had.
We heard.
Galloping too fast, breathless, smashed a farmer's fence and scared the chickens. As you know, before the wagon he had the boat of fever, managed to send a half dozen boats to the bottom, smashing into rocks and sunken trees, that sort of thing.
He does manage to pick up crazes.
His crazes always mean trouble for friends and neighbors. I've had several talks to Toad. Each time he promises to behave, but he never does. I wouldn't bother with him, except I promised Toad's father I'd keep an eye on him. Toad's father and I were the best of
friends. Should we find our boat and get started?
Lead on, Ratty.
Ratty prepped a marvelous lunch.
Hello, Badger.
Hello, Ratty.
Hello, Mole.
Hello.
You humans seem to be in a great hurry.
They were chasing us.
They're always chasing us.
They think it's fine, but not for us.
Who do you mean? Did you ask?
The weasels who live in the wild wood.
Ah, yes.
Nasty chaps, those weasels. You live in the wild, Badger, and I don't know how you do it.
Those weasels wouldn't dare trifle with me. Besides, I've lived in the wild wood longer than any other animal. Long before the weasels showed up.
I wish they'd never come to Wildwood.
Daytime is bad enough, but nighttime is a terror.
I rarely go out at night. If they continue to prove this nuisance, let me know. I know how to deal with troublemakers.
Thank you, Badger.
Think nothing of it.
And don't talk no matter what they say.
Leave everything to me.
Do you really intend to speak to those weasels?
If the situation warrants it, I can be quite aggressive at times. Don't let my age fool you.
I'm never going to Wildwood. The place keeps me creeps. Sorry, Badger.
No need to apologize. Although, my home is in the Wildwood. It's comfy and warm in winter, and comfy and cool in the summer. I have no intention of moving.
The world is our great heroes, and the hit people to show. But never meant to go down for fame, compared with a Toad.
It's Toad!
I went to Toad Hall, Toad. You weren't home.
The clever man at Oxford knows all that there should be known, but none of them won half as much as intelligent Mr. Toad. Do you like it, Badger? I wrote to myself, of course.
Of course.
A bit conceited, don't you think?
Conceited? I'm the least conceited person I know. The queen and the ladies-in-waiting sat in a window and sewed. She cried, "Look, who's that handsome man?" They answered, "Mr. Toad." There are several more verses.
I'm sure there are. Some other time, perhaps.
But you don't know what you're missing.
I think I do.
We're going on a picnic. Ratty prepped a marvelous lunch.
Do join us.
I am a bit hungry.
We've rented a boat.
A picnic on a boat? How distasteful. What if the boat capsized and one fell into the water?
You ought to know.
I'm quite finished with boats. Childish nonsense, silly amusements. I've given that long ago. I have been in Ukraine.
Toad, must I remind you of your rightly painted wagon? The one you smashed. That too was in Ukraine.
Pish-posh, I finally discovered what I'm meant for.
What's that, Toad?
Beg your pardon, sir. There's a sailor in the hall. Says you're expecting. my river.
It's everybody's river.
Take the picnic basket and tell the salesman I'll be there in a moment or two.
Yes, sir.
Motoring in a motor car.
We much prefer your roller skate craze.
Glorious steering sights, the poetry of motion.
Don't be a fool.
What does Paul feel spring up behind me as we speed on my reckless ways?
No, Toad, you mustn't.
Think of all the hay wagons, I shall fling carelessly in the ditch as you drive my marvelous new motor car. Out of the way, Roadhogs, here comes Toad, king of the road!
Ho, 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 ho. He's off again.
What are we gonna do with him?
I'm afraid there's nothing to be done. His latest craze will simply have to wear itself out. In the meantime, I suggest we have our lunch.
Rich. We all know that, but he won't be for much longer.
many motor cars has Mr. Toad demolished?
Counting this latest?
Yes.
This latest makes 7.
7 smash-ups. Just think about it.
He will insist on driving himself, and he's no good at it. If only he can employ a decent, steady, well-trained animal, pay him good wages, leave everything to me, get on all right.
That's not how Mr. Toad looks at things. He's convinced he's a wonderful driver and nobody can teach him anything. So stubborn he is. Cute, but stubborn.
On the railroad, Bob! Here comes Toad! King of the road! Hop, 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 hop!
It's Mr. Toad!
Out of the hospital!
Let's not stand about! Our very lives are in danger!
Again?
On the contrary, I faithfully promise that the very first motor car I
be unguarded as much as an instant.
Cut the cells in the nick of time. He's about to drive off. How about tea? My housekeeper's making cucumber sandwiches. I'm driving with a fly on top. Why are you looking at me like that?
For your own good, Toad.
What is?
Think of a fun we shall all have together until you've gotten over this painful craze of yours.
We'll stay until you're well.
I am well.
No more regrettable incidents with the police?
Help!
Get him!
No! No! I want my new motor car! Help! 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 Help!
Tasty and mysterious.
fellow Raffi, but very little education and intelligence. I must take him in hand one day and see if I can make something of him.
Ah, the Red Lion. Best launch you on short notice.
Now, there's a fine looking piece of work. It's a motor car, and it's red. It's quite unattended. I wonder if this vehicle could start up easily. I'll give it a try. Where's the harm in that?
Thank you. village and then he got out of prison.
Well, that's because the prison ain't a hotel. I wish your father would get over his nasty cold. It's no pleasure for me to take on his duties, I can tell you.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Toad.
As for Toad, I'm tired of his sobs and complaints.
He's so unhappy. Put him under my care. You know how fond of my animals I am. I'll have him eating out of my hand in no time.
I find that disgusting. Don't know what your father would say, but if you want to waste your time with a mean-tempered toad, you're one of them, I'm sure.
When do the rest of us eat?
I'm hungry!
Silence!
There you are, Mr. Toad. Did you have a nice nap?
What does matter? What does anything matter?
Chin up. Look what happened to you. A nice little tea and some hot buttered toast.
I don't think I shall ever eat again!
I sprinkle cinnamon on the toast. He likes cinnamon.
Doom, that's what I am. Doom.
You do carry on.
That this could happen to the popular and handsome Toad, the rich and hospitable Toad. Toad is so free and careless and debonair, I'm getting what I deserve. Stealing a beautiful motor car and calling an officer a flatfoot. A stupid animal I was. Did you put extra butter on my toast?
Just for you.
Perhaps a nibble or two. I must languish in this terrible dungeon until people who knew me are proud to say they've forgotten the very name of Toad. Wise and old badger, clever, intelligent rat, sensible mole. I can't taste the cinnamon. If it has no interest in me, I shan't eat another nibble.
Stand straight, Mr. Toad. Draw your tears and be a sensible animal. I have something to tell you.
Well, what is it?
I want to be your friend.
You've been very kind.
I've enjoyed you telling about Toad Hall. Must be a wonderful place.
Been in the family for centuries. Why would you want to be my friend?
I like animals. I have a canary.
A canary? How nice.
And I think you're given an awful sentence. 20 years. It's not right. It's not fair.
If only you were the judge.
I think I can help you.
No one can help me. Toad is due.
Do be quiet, Mr. Toad. You talk too much. That's your problem. Listen carefully.
If you say so, Polly.
I have an aunt who's a washerwoman.
I have several aunts who ought to be a washerwoman.
She does all the washing for the prisoners in the fortress. We try to keep any paying business of that sort of family. You understand?
One hand washes the other. Yeah, I quite understand.
She takes up the washing on Monday and brings it in on Friday.
That's today.
Exactly. Now this is what occurs to me. You're rich. She's poor. A few pounds won't make any difference to you. I've spoken to her, and she's agreeable.
I'm not falling, I'm afraid.
You can escape wearing some of her clothes.
Yes, yes, splendid. What a wonderful idea. But you see here, you're not suggesting Toad of Toad Hall to go to the countryside disguised as a washerwoman?
I'm trying to help you. I suppose you'd rather leave the prison in a coach and four.
You are a good, kind, clever girl. I'm a stupid Toad. But I dislike discussing money. I find it vulgar. I'll just put the money on the table and say nothing.
Whatever you wish, I'll get her.
You mean she's here?
In the hallway.
This looks most promising.
This is Auntie.
How you do, dearie? I got a print gown, an apron, a shawl, and a bonnet with a string for under the chin. Is that money I see?
I don't see any money.
I do. Now, you understand that the
oldest dresses. The bonnet, too, my grandmother Shaw.
How do I look?
I've seen better.
You'll do.
Beggars can't be choosers, I suppose. Don't you think this dress makes me look a bit dowdy?
Now you must tie me up. There's a rope in the bundle. Fetch it, Polly.
Tie you up? How undignified and grateful. No, no, I won't hear of it.
Silence, you stupid toad, and do as I say.
There's no need to be rude.
Auntie wants a guard to think. You go without her.
That way I can keep my job. Wouldn't want to lose my situation.
I understand completely. You're a sensible woman.
I want to look like the victim of circumstances.
And so you shall. Do you really think the guards will think of her? I am so much better looking.
Mind your manners. It's me who's doing the favor, not the other way around.
Quite.
Goodbye, Toad, and good luck. Go straight down the hallway and turn left. If anyone says anything.
I know.
Once you're outside, you're on your own.
I can't thank you enough, Polly. Oh, hello, boys. Fine day.
Next. I want you to be happy. It does my heart good.
You mean very kind.
Think nothing of cover, I'll tidy up the barge.
I imagine it's a mess.
How's that?
You said you were hauling coal.
Yes, ma'am, coal.
No guns, no swords, no snakes.
whatsoever.
But the sentinels will be posted out as usual.
Outside, that's where the tunnel comes in. We'll rush at the butler's patch and whack those weasels and whack him, whack him, whack him.
Serve them right.
What if the foxes rush in?
We'll have to arm ourselves, but first, we'd better dance. We'll need our strength.
Good idea.
Leave it to me. I'll take care of those sentries. Child's play.
No, no, down with toes. Smash him, put him in the trash.
Attention. My, my, what fine sentries.
Back him, nip him, give him a crash.
At ease. Move along, Granny. Don't want no gawkers hanging about.
No trespassers either.
And no riffraff. Want any lodging done today?
Thank you.
You can't imagine what I've been through.
You can't imagine what I've been through.
Some of them ran into the closet and slammed the door.
The Riverbank group delights at your back.
Quite.
A party must be expected.
Oh, good. I love parties. I shall propose a program. How's this? A speech by Toad followed by an address by Toad. I'll speak on our prison system and its rights and its students. Some songs will be sung by the composer. That's me.
Look here, Toad. We want you to understand clearly, once and for all, that there'll be no songs nor speeches sung by you. You must learn humility.
Try to grasp the fact that in this occasion, we are not arguing with you.
We're telling you.
Could I just sing one little song? The Toad came home?
No!
You have pondered, my friends. The past is the past. Life has taught me much. You need never be concerned for Mr. Toad, as he has before. And you shall never blush for me ever again. But oh dear, this is a hard world.
We'll leave the money to you. Since this is such a special occasion, I'll outdo myself. We'll have cold chicken, cold tongue, cold ham, peanut butter jelly sandwiches, pickles, salad, french rolls, watercress, tea biscuits, potted meat, ginger beer, lemonade, and soda water.
More than once.